A lot of clients come in and talk to me about child support issues, and a big one is, how is child support collected? And how also is it calculated? Well, first, it's calculated by using the child support guidelines. Those were promulgated by the Iowa Supreme Court, and we first look at each parent's gross income. That would be income before any taxes or any other deductions. Then each parent is allowed certain deductions under the guidelines. And we will then get to a number that I would call net income for each parent. We then add those two numbers together and get family net income. We then go to our guideline charts, and in the chart we'll have a place for the combined family net income, and then also a place for the number of children for child support. Where those two cells intersect will give us an actual dollar number. That dollar number then needs to be divided between the parents, and it's divided based on your respective incomes. So if the parents have a combined family net income of $4,000, and one parent has $2,500 and the other one has $1,500, you do the simple math. $1,500 divided by $4,000, that's one parent's percentage, and then $2,500 divided by $4,000 is the other parent's percentage. We also factor in health insurance and a couple other things that make the calculation a little more complex. But the basic idea is that whatever that dollar number was in the chart, you multiply by each parent's respective percentage, and then you get their basic child support obligation. Now, if a parent has physical care, they will receive child support from the parent who has visitation. If the parents have joint physical care, we will calculate child support as if one parent would pay to the other, and then we'll run it the other way. And whoever has the higher child support obligation will pay the difference between the two calculations. So if one parent would pay $500 a month and the other one would pay $300 a month, you'd subtract, and one parent wound up paying the other $200 a month. And then they would normally split other expenses for the children equally. There are some other unusual issues that might come up with child support calculation, and so it'd be important to talk to a lawyer if any of those come up. When it comes to collection of child support, there's a couple different methods. The first would be an income withholding order, where an order is sent to a person's employer, and then they take it out of that person's paycheck every time they get paid, and they send it to the central agency with the state of Iowa to receive those payments, and then it is sent to the person who should receive the child support payment. Another method would be the payor of child support could write a check or cash and send it to the clerk of court for the county in which the judgment was entered. And then the clerk of court would process the payment and then send it on to the recipient. If someone's not paying child support, then you could contact your local child support recovery unit to see what options they could give you. But you could also contact a private lawyer and file a contempt action to try to collect.